Did you believe it was the White House chief of staff?
All I can tell you is that at 10 o'clock on Thursday morning, he talked with Senator Durbin. Mm-hmm. Senator Durbin indicated we had a bipartisan proposal. He ran through it with the president. The president says, that sounds very good. Let's talk about it. I think the president actually gave some interviews with the Washington Journal or somebody about 10:30, saying he feels like we're close to a breakthrough. So all I can tell you is I don't know what happened between 10 and 12. The meeting did not go well, and we are where we are.
What John Kelly has said publicly is what happened is that he actually got the details of the proposal from the perspective of conservatives. And he realized that what you're saying is something that he was convinced that what you are saying and what
I think there's
is
some people around the president in the White House, and John Kelly's a wonderful man, an American hero if there ever was one. He's done a good job of creating order out of chaos, but on immigration, I've been dealing with it for about 10 years. I know where the bandwidth exists, what you can and can't do in phase one, and there's still some room. The president laid out a pretty good idea, but there's people in his ear in the White House who are outliers. There are people on his staff who have been working in the Senate that are well known to be complete.
Who are you talking about, Stephen Miller? I mean, name names.
There are people around the president
who have
an irrational view of immigration. They always have, and if you follow that lead, we'll never get anywhere. Let me tell you where we can go. You won an election based on we need to secure our border. Mr. President, hats off to you for winning the election. You deserve to start securing our border. You're right about a wall. We need a wall. We need to start the wall now. You're right about these kids are wonderful kids. I'm sure there are a few bad people. They're mostly good kids. You're right about compassion and insecurity and love. That's the way you get a deal. All I can tell you is that you're not going to get comprehensive on the Republican side, which a lot of people are pushing you. You have good instincts. Close the deal. The guy Tuesday laid out what the deal should look like. Now let's just close it.
Is John Kelly one of the people around the president that is irrational when it comes to immigration?
I don't think John Kelly's irrational. I think he has never closed a deal before. Politically,
keeping you from the deal?
I don't know the inner workings of the White House, but I do know this. It took us weeks to get a border proposal. You know, he accused a lot of us of fiddling around. I've been working on this for 10 years. We still don't have a plan from the White House what diversity lottery should be replaced with. We still don't know what they want on chain migration, other than comprehensive. All I can say is that the border proposal we got, I could support, but there's no way you're going to get all of that for the DACA population. Here's what I'm trying to tell folks. The Democrats got to have leverage for the rest of the 11 million. If they give us all we want on border and go to merit-based immigration, why would they ever expect us to deal with the rest of the 11 million illegal immigrants? Conversely, what if we legalize the 11 million? Do you think they would ever, Democrats, deal with us on border and merit-based immigration? We have no leverage. So phase one is a down payment on everything.
Can you tell me what happened in that meeting, in your own words?
No, I can tell you this.
Why not? Why don't you?
Because I want to make sure that I can keep talking to the president. I told him what I thought, and that's more important to me than anything else.
He did call those countries shithole countries. You can confirm that.
You can keep asking me all day long, and I'm going to tell you the same thing. Why don't you ask me, is he a racist?
That was my next question.
Okay, why don't you ask me?
Do you think that he is a racist?
Absolutely not. Let me tell you why. You could be dark as charcoal and lily white. It doesn't matter, as long as you're nice to him. You could be the Pope and criticize him. It doesn't matter. He'll go after the Pope. You could be Putin and say nice things, and he'll like you. Here's what I found. He's a street fighter. It's not the color of your skin that matters. It's not the content of your character. It's whether or not you show him respect and like him. And if he feels like